involves application of variable structure systems, higher sliding mode concept to control and observe uncertain systems. He is a winner of Scopus Prize for the best cited Mexican scientist in mathematics and engineering, 2010.
Dr. Friedman earned Doctor of Science in Controls at Moscow State University of Mathematics and Electronics in the year 1998 and his PhD in Applied Mathematics at Institute of Control Science, Moscow in the year 1988. He has worked as a faculty member for 24 years in the Department of Mathematics in the Samara State Architecture and Civil Engineering University and 2 years in Chihuahua Institute of Technology at Mexico. And at present, he is a professor at the Department of Control and Robotics Division of Electrical Engineering at National Autonomous University of Mexico, which he joined in the year 2002.
So now, with a huge round of applause, let's welcome Dr. Friedman to enlighten us on 5 generations of sliding mode controllers, stages of evolution.
Thank you.
So, it is my big pleasure to be here. No, yes, I think it's you can hear. And I've devoted this plenary precisely to collaboration of my group. And you see here two signs simultaneously. That's Mexican flag to deal with a sign, typical sign of sliding mode. So, and a group developed here in India by Professor Bijnan Banjapai. And here in CIT, I have members of department working on my sign. And I'm really grateful to them to invite me in order to deliver my knowledge about stages of my life, because my life is 100% in sliding mode control. And the point is that the collaboration allows us to make precisely the next step. But of course, plenary is not the time to write plenty of formulas. Plenary is the time when you have to explain the stuff in qualitative level. So I do apologize if you will see some formulas on my slide, but anyway, I will try to speak qualitatively what we have done in these last maybe 30 years. And also what we are doing now, collaborating with your colleagues here in India, and that is an example when we can reach something together, and I'm really grateful to say that curiosity of some of your friends from India helped us to develop a new stage. So let us start. The first stuff, I apologize for formula, will be precisely the simplest example of sliding mode control system. Let us see. This chair. What's happened? I'm putting it and it doesn't move. Why? Why it doesn't move? Because you have discontinuous friction. You have column friction. So let us make a model, and you see that if it is velocity, and if your friction is strong enough, it doesn't matter which perturbation you are applying, because nothing will happen. So, and you can understand, if your friction will be more strong than perturbation, you will not move. So what will happen? If you are not moving, your velocity is zero. So the question is, what is sine of zero? Sine of zero, is it a function or it is a set? So because the velocity for any perturbation has the same level. It's every time zero. So that's the first step. People are understanding what they will do when they will try to apply discontinuous control. They should deal with inclusion. They cannot deal with equations. So let us see the same example from the other viewpoint. Imagine that you need to catch some prisoner. What you are doing? You are asking two policemen, and they will bring the person. And if he would like to escape, what they will do? They will push him strong at each step, and he has no chance to escape. If the policemen are strong enough. So that's another example people thinking when they are starting to use discontinuous control. So let us see this example with policemen from the viewpoint of control. Who are the policemen? Policemen are actuators. So what will happen if they will do their strategy? Pushing at each step a prisoner, what will happen? Two things. Or they will tell, okay, we are tight, we will not work for such a small salary you are paying us. Or they will kill the victims. That's the point. So that's two problems which are arising when you are starting to deal with sliding mode control. First of all, you need to make very strong restriction for actuators if they are able to work with high frequency. And second, if they are able, pay attention to the plant. Maybe you will destroy it because your plant is victim. So in that sense. So that's two things, and you see the question, mathematical question, people should solve when they would like to apply discontinuous control. First of all, they need to work with inclusion, not with the equation. You see, here I don't know perturbation, so it is inclusion. And in reality, you have to feel this one. And another story is a finite time conversion. If you will use a Lipschitz control, you will every time have a convergence, maybe, but you will never reach it being alive. So that is why maybe people were thinking, okay, I will go to the church, I will have very good behavior, and if I will die, I will be happy. But I would like to be to have not so ideal behavior, and I would like to die to be happy before I will die. So can I have finite time convergence? That's precisely a point we can see here. Moreover, let us return to the chair. So imagine that I know the friction. If I know the friction, I know perturbation. That's the third law of Newton. So that's the second idea which is behind. So if I can reconstruct the control level, I can reconstruct perturbation. So what I can do, I can use such a strategy for full detection and stuff like that. That's how it works. So let us go to this history. So what people had, this is an example. You see here perturbation, and you see that perturbation here is dominated by sine. So what we will have? We will take the solution and bring it to the discontinuous surface, and it is okay. But this is the price to pay. This is so-called chattering effect, when your policemen are beating in each step a prisoner. So what you will have? you will have here black box and it will be your problem. But if you will filter out this, what you will have? You will reconstruct perturbation. And that's also a good point. If you can reconstruct perturbation, you can make system identification, full detection, stuff like that. So, in the for mechanical system with drive friction, it is also clear what you can do. So, you can stop the car. Why? Because you have drive friction. If you will have smooth friction, you will never stop the car because maximum you can have is asymptotic convergence, no more. So, but it is not reality. In reality, drive friction helps you to stop the car. But the point is, if you will stop the car, you will control the same here, velocity. If you will control velocity, it's okay. But what will happen with position? If you'd like to stop, you need to stop before stamp, not after. That's also good stuff. So that is why in the later 50s, in the late 50s, we had, first of all, we have understood that we can stop, but we are not sure that we are stopped in correct way. So how to control a position, not only velocity? And we need to control them in spite of perturbation. And it will be maybe possible, but to make such a stuff working, people should have a mathematical method to analyze that equation with discontinuous reaction cycle. So, and then the science was started because it was people, but good mathematicians from seminar of Pontryagin was entered in the field and they made the first step. This step was announced precisely in the first IFA Congress in 1960, and it was made by Professor Filippov. He made a very, very sympathetic and mathematically sound definition of solution. He told, okay, the main point, if you are dealing with discontinuous equation, you should consider inclusion. What I need to do, imagine that I would like to follow the curve. If I'd like to follow the curve, what I need to be every time in the tangential surface. Otherwise, I will leave it. So, and he's shown that if we have two vectors of right-hand side, what we need to just to make a convex hull. So what does it mean? This time we need just to connect the end of the vector and ask the God to keep us in tangential surface. So good, but it is not sound engineering. Imagine the people in the 60s, they've attended the presentation by Professor Filippov, they've applauded and thought, okay, that's a mathematical game, doesn't work. So, and then engineers come, and you see here the two principal ideas. They was proposed by my scientific advisor, Professor Rutkin, and the first idea was so-called equivalent control. He told, okay guys, what we need to be every time to follow some constraints. What does it mean? This means that we should have such a control allowing us to be in every time in tangential surface. What we will do? We will write the equation, differential equation for this surface, and we will consider U a control like a known variable. If we will do that, what we will have? We will have an algebraic equation, and we, if this matrix, which is gradient of surface by control matrix, will be invertible, so no problem. We have simple algebraic equation and we can substitute the solution inside of the solution. So if we will do that, okay, we will slide. Why? Because if you will see and if you will start in the surface, you should multiply this by g, which is gradient of sigma, and you will say have gx dot gf gb gb minus 1 will be annihilated. Gf my gf my minus gf, you will have zero. So what does it mean? If you will start to slide, you will never go outside. And that maybe was a first step transferring the problem from very mathematical one to more or less engineering solution. So, and then it was the second step. The second step was the following. What's the difference between math and engineering? Mathematicians should prove the problem stated by God. Engineers should solve the problem. So, what happened there? What happened is that you need to stop a car in position zero and velocity zero. And how to do it if you have just one control for two variables? So, mathematicians was unable to answer this question because they was working with just dry friction and they cannot solve this problem. But engineers thought, okay, but we can move the surface we are switching. If we will move the surface, what we will have? We will have a surface we want, so we will have desired behavior of the system like this one, and C will be in our hands. So what's the solution of the system? It is an exponentially decreasing function. So, and C, the velocity of decreasing, will be in our hand. So, how we will do the sliding mode control? We will do the sliding mode control like a state is making, like a government is doing. So, what they are doing? For the bad people, when they have, perturbation, they are using policy. Policy will be, in that sense, sliding mode control. Sliding mode control will reject perturbation and bring to the people to the correct way to live. And these people, and in this way, they will track without necessary to do every time because they will live in ideal world because the perturbation will be rejected by policy which is sliding mode control. So, after that, people have understood how to do sliding mode control. They need to have two stages instead of one. First of all, to understand, maybe to call to the church and ask what the behavior is decided, is desired, and then ask to policy to follow this behavior. So, this means that first you need to make desired surface, and then sliding mode control, relay control, will compensate perturbation and you will go to the surface and you will reach the paradigm. But the problem was that I've changed the words. I've told you why. Because I've promised you to be happy being alive. And this behavior is still not that because we will have asymptotic convergence. So that is why it was not complete solution. And this is precisely what's happened. So, you see here the result, and after all, I will show you the illustrated video. It's very simple, it's double integrated. So it's some perturbed system. You have here perturbation with different frequency and also constant. So what you will have? You will have finally a surface. It is the simplest possible. And you will arrive to the surface and then slide. So, of course, despite of perturbation, the conditions, the convergence will be to the error will converge to zero, but this is a pavement. The pavement is a chattering. So you need to avoid a chattering canoe. So, and that was the price to pay, and that is why in the 80s people have understood the following, that they can compensate much uncertainty theoretically exactly, but it supposes that all of the states are available. So moreover, the sliding mode itself reduced design of control solution into some reduced order system. And the first finite time conservation, you will have just to the surface, but not to the region. So, and disadvantages are also here. The main one is a chattering. So, what problem was opened? We started our work with my friend Professor Levine. The problem was that it was necessary to substitute discontinuous control, which was destroying the system, to continuous one, but with the same property. Second, reduce the dimension of sliding dimension, maybe for sliding surface, maybe for more than one. So in the case of double integrator, if you will, let's say, make a sliding surface of dimension, of codimension 2, so you will arrive to 0 in finite time, so, and I will complete the goal. And to do that, we need the complete state. For example, for double integrator, you need some differentiator which will be work well and which also will converge in finite time, which is looking strange from mathematical viewpoint, because you see, if even you don't have noises, the operator is not bounded, so it is a problem. So now I will, and that's more or less the stuff all of the people know from Halil book, and it is a classical part of control. Now, not all of them, not all knows the next stages we've passed in our sliding mode community, and that's precisely a topic of this talk. The next stage was second order sliding mode controller. What was an idea? So we started to work with it in early 80s together with Professor Levin. Here we are adult men, so we don't have good photos of us from this period. And the first result was a PhD by Professor Levin. What he is doing, what he was done, what was the main idea? Imagine that you need to reduce a chattering. What does it mean? This means that you need to reduce all of energy you are spending to follow the surface to reject perturbation. How to do it? You need not only follow the restriction. You need to ensure that also velocity will be very small, because what's happened? You've seen my pictures, black box. You see that you are using all of energy of the system in each step. So that is why the idea was to reduce the energy. If you can reduce the energy, you can reduce the chattering and you can make such a compensation of perturbation much more simple. So, and that was precisely the point of second order sliding mode controller. What does it mean, second order sliding mode controller? This means that you need to elaborate such a control law allowing you to make simultaneously small an error in the tracking and also a rare error in its velocity. So, you see here for double integrator, it's a very simple controller called twisting controller. How it works? Imagine that I need to move this chair to the angle. What I need first, yes, the idea was precisely to try to move it. So I need to put the force more than drag friction. And then when I passing the angle, the acceleration will change the sign, I have to return, and then I will make some more switches. And finally, what will happen? You see here a fast plane. So I'm starting to move, I'm changing here velocity, here acceleration. So, and I will have infinite number of switches, but the point is that I will have here then a phenomenon. What does it mean? This means that the series between time switches will converge in finite time. And I will converge to zero in finite time, not only for position, also for velocity. So, what does it mean? This means that for mechanical system I will complete what I promised you. This means that I will be happy and even being alive. So, I don't know the dynamics. The only I would like to know that my forces, my friction will be more than more strong than dynamics, and the force I'm applying to the position will be more than the sum of force. So, and finally, you see the difference here. You see, what I'm doing here, I'm applying this twisting controller to the same system, and what I'll have? I'll have a finite and convergent to both position and velocity. That will be a behavior, but you see, the chattering is still here. So how I can use this idea to avoid the chattering? Imagine that I have general system, and I'm designing some surface, and this is precisely equation for this surface. And what I will do? I will put not discontinuous controller, but I will put this twisting controller like an integrator. So what I will have? I will have continuous controller. I will have even Lipschitz controller, which allowing us to reach the constraint in finite time. But I will not apply discontinuous control, so I will have much less chatter. What was the pro and contra? Pro was the following. If I'd like to use such a control, I need to have sigma dot to realize it. Why? Because I have sigma dot here. If I will have sigma dot here, what will happen? I will know perturbation, because I know this part and I know this, so I will know also perturbation. And if I know perturbation, why I need to make such a strong controller like a sliding mode controller? I will simply compensate it. But it doesn't work for the case of not only black box, but also for the case of gray box, because if I don't know exactly the gain of control, I cannot use such a strategy. And even the knowledge of derivative is needed to compensate the perturbation. So this strategy was good, but it was not excellent. Why? Because we need the knowledge of sigma dot. So advantages of second order sliding mode was that we can compensate bounded perturbation, but also Lipschitz one. They should be Lipschitz, because you cannot ask the god to compensate a strong perturbation with weak control. The perturbation should be the same class of the control. Otherwise, you cannot guarantee nothing. So, and moreover, such approach gave us much better precision. Why? Because when you have small error, it is good, but if you together with this, you have small error in derivative, so you will have square precision for the coordinate. So this means that the second order sliding mode allows you to have much better perceived. So, and what problems was open to the end of 90s? Okay, we can reduce maybe a chattering when we are returning to the relative degree one, but the point was that we still use the derivatives. Derivatives is a lot of problems, even if you, you don't have noise. So, what was the open question, first of all? To try to make a control which allows you to stabilize simultaneously the system is arbitrary relative degree, or and to do it without knowledge of derivatives. So you see this here is comparison between first order and second order sliding mode. In the first order sliding mode it was necessary the surface. In the second order sliding mode the surface was not necessary anymore, and of course we have here for the output this quadratic precision. Good. In parallel, the team of Professor Mang in Australia, they've made the other idea, they've realized so-called integral, so-called terminal sliding mode. It was simply finite M controller, which allowing us, because we have here the degree less than one, to have finite M converter. But what they've done, they've adding to this a sign, discontinuous controller. So what's happened? Mathematically it was a big problem because you see here, if you are trying to find relative degree, you immediately have the discontinuous term, no chance to do that. And it was a real problem, but in reality, what's happened? Two types of behavior of such system. One, you are reaching the parabola, but this parabola is a bad one. Why? Because you have infinite gain here. If you have infinite gain, a little bit dangerous, but nevertheless it converges in finite time. Another story for different values of parameter is that you never will slide on this surface, but you will have twisting-like behavior, and finally you will converge in finite time. So that was two main approaches to second-order sliding mode control. And finally, so what we have? It was necessary to do the same stuff, but without using a degree of derivative and without infinite gain in the surface. So, and why super twisting the reason? What is super twisting? Super twisting is the following: the same system, but as a controller, we've used a combination. One of them is finite M controller. And one, and the second one, is a compensator of derivative of uncertainty. This control is continuous, and if the perturbations are Lipschitz, so we can have the same behavior like twisting, but we will have finite M convergence without need of derivatives. So what happened here? You see. Here, you have the same surface, you are converging to the same surface, but without chattering. Let us see a couple of movies which we've made in my lab thanks to the Quanser. Thank you, Tom. So, as precisely, Quanser inverted pendulum, and you see, to stabilize it, we've used first order sliding mode control, and this lambada means chattering. So, don't believe that it will work more than 4 minutes. After 4 minutes, you have to change the motor. Now, the same experiment, the same equipment, but let us see what in reality happened. Between first order sliding motor control and second one. So no chattering, and my student for curiosity left this pendulum for all the night and nothing happened. So, we was happy because it was, we felt that we won the problem of chattering, which was a key point for our science, and we reduced the chattering, and we, moreover, what happened there is that we've made something very special. Why? Because normally, problem of differentiation is very strong and it is difficult to solve it. But here we have finite time convergence. What does it mean? How we can use it to make a differentiation? Very simple. You see, imagine that you have some signal and you can ensure the convergence of error of estimation of difference between such a signal and the signal of some artificial and the output of some artificial system, we can ensure the convergence for function, for error, and for derivative. So what does it mean? This means that if you will use super twisting here, you will have an error between estimation of the signal and the signal itself, zero after finite time. So what does it mean? You will have finite time differentiator. So normally if you are using MATLAB, you are using their filters and stuff like that. Otherwise it doesn't work. And the filters producing delay. So what is behind? People are telling how it works, because if you'd like to have derivative, you need to filter out and automatically time delay. So, where is the filter here? What we are doing? What we are paying for? The point is here. So, what we need here is to ask the God that not only derivative, but its second derivative, not only derivative of signal, but its second derivative should be bounded. So, we are putting the filter down on the table, and this filter this kind of filter giving us a finite time convergence to the derivative if we don't have a noise. But a second question was, okay, if we have a noise, what will happen? We returned at that moment to mathematicians, and they told us it was a classical theorem by Kolmogorov, which showed that if you have some noise, the maximum error one can have is a square root of noise. You cannot do better. So, and it turns that this algorithm do realize such precision. We have shown it mathematically, that with this algorithm, which we have the better possible mathematically possible precision. And that's very important. It was our, let's say, surprise, because, let's see, how we can return from control, how we can pay back to mathematics. And this differentiator is real-time differentiator, allowing us to do that. So, after that, in the late of 20th century, we still have good and bad in control. First of all, we've made continuous control instead of this continuous one, but it was compensated just Lipschitz uncertainty. We attenuated the chattering, but it was not complete removal, but it was because the filter was behind. And we've obtained robust exact differentiator, which in comparison with the other one was converging in finite time, and in reality it can give us best possible precision in the sense of Kolmogorov. So which problem was open? First of all, what to do with system with relative degree more than two. Second, how to extend the differentiators. Why? Because if you are applying differentiators step by step, you should put every time square root of error. So imagine what does it mean. This means that if you have 10 minus 4 sensor and you will apply differentiators step by step, you need to pay, you will have just 10% of precision when you will make estimation of acceleration. It is too much. So, the same work by Kolmogorov was telling us that it is not the best way to do, and we need to make a special, if we need highest order differentiators, we need to construct it in the special way, because if you know that the system is, the signal is smooth, and you, for example, when you need acceleration, you have to suppose that this, your signal is more smooth, because otherwise, what you need? You need, you just can't find just the first derivative. And that was the principal point. The principal point was how to estimate the highest derivative and how to make specialized differentiator, which allowing us to make best possible precision for the highest derivative. And it is very important even for simple mechanical system, because if you'd like to do something with the mechanical system, what you need to identify accelerations, then to make some forces, to identify some forces, to identify some errors, make parameter identification, whatever. So, and that was a next stage. So, and we've made arbitrary order of Leibniz control. Here is an example. What we are doing, we have a relative degree R system, and we don't know practically nothing. We know more or less where is the dynamics, And also we know more or less the sign of control gain, no more. So, what we can do in that sense? It's for sure not black box, but it is at least gray, because the only you know is an estimation of relative degree, no more. So, and here you are, for example, third and fourth order algorithm. How they are working? In the style I was telling you when I told about terminal control. So, we've constructed this surface which is looking like parabola. We need to approach this surface, and then following the surface we are approaching to parabola, and then we are going to zero. Here is the third order. The fourth order is constructed in a similar way. So, and you see here precisely what we need to realize them. We need the derivatives. So we need a good differentiator. So this is differentiator constructed using, like, by the same idea. Here you use an example of fourth order differentiator. Of course, I wouldn't like to write all of general differentiator, but you can receive it for any order. So, finally, that was a concept we finished with. This is a general new concept of higher order sliding mode. What do you need to realize higher order sliding mode? What do you need to be happy in finite time, being alive? You need just to have upper estimation of relative degree, and you need to have an idea of the value of your variables, because you know that in real life all the variables are bounded. So if it is so, you are taking the output, you need to differentiate it r minus one time, and then put r order controller. So what you will have finally finite and convergence, and you will be happy being alive. So it is all, no, it's still not. Why? Because of course the same idea was behind Oichi's idea, that maybe we can do something like continuous controller for them. Why we need to use this continuous one if our perturbation looks like Lipschitz no more? So, and that was precisely a fifth stage. We started to work with the people from IIT Bombay. And moreover, it was their question. They asked me, Professor, You are good. You told us how to control mechanical system. For example, if you need, you can put there extra differentiator, and you can put there the system as the control as smooth you want. But how we can reduce the number of derivatives we need to reach zero? For example, for double integrator. And then it was a question they started me and my colleague, Professor Jaime Morena, to ask. That's the team we are dealing with. It's my co-author, Professor Jaime Morena, from Institute of Engineering of UNAM. And this is Professor Bijnan Banjapai. I suppose that majority in this hall knows him. And here are two of his PhD students, now both are doctors, Professor Shyam Kamal and Atif Chalanga. So what we've offered? We've offered different families of continuous controller. How it works? You see, this is a double integrator. And here is a controller. What he has? He has two parts. One is precisely the finite time part. These degrees are less than one, and that's precisely the stuff allowing us finite time convergence. And here, what we have integral of sine function. This zero means that, you see in this formula, if it is zero, it's just a sine. So it's a sine function. It looks like twisting. It's sine of position and sine of velocity. And this is for compensation of perturbation. Such a controller allows us to make this behavior of the system. You see, we have here finite time convergence, and moreover, the value of control converges in finite time to perturbation. That was a principal result received, and moreover, because this controller is in reality third order sliding mode controller, we've reached the most important goal. The most important goal is that, I will show you maybe the table to understand what really happened. So, you see, this is precisely stages I've told you. Stage number one, the controller, and it is applying to the double integrator. So stage number one, we have sliding discontinuous controller, we've used position and velocity, we have finite asymptotic convergence, and the precision was of order 1 because we have discontinuous derivative, so integrating we have just sampling step. Second stage was a second order of sliding mode controller. To realize it, we use still discontinuous controller. We have the information of sigma and sigma dot, and we had finite time conversion. So what we want? We want just the precision. Why? Because if the derivative was small, integrating it twice, we have delta square precision. So then it was super twisting, the third stage. In the third stage, we transformed controller from discontinuous to continuous one. We used the same information, but because we was using a surface, the convergence was asymptotic and precision was still of order 2. Then, higher order sliding mode control is represented here as a third order through integrator. So we had a continuous controller, but to realize third order sliding mode controller, it was necessary the information about acceleration. So we are losing precision here, and moreover, if we know the control gain, what we can? We can simply compensate the perturbation, because if we know acceleration, we can compensate perturbation. No problem with that. And after all, we have finite time convergence and precision of order 3. And the last stage, thanks to our collaboration with IIT Bombay, we've realized continuous second order sliding mode controller, which in reality gives us of precision of the third order sliding mode, but we are using the same information of sigma and sigma dot. So finally, that was 5 stages we've passed last 30 years, and then the state of art for the moment. I only would like to show you a couple of other videos. I also couple of other videos. I also would like to next time to tell thank you to Kwanza. And you see, that's precisely how it works in reality. Now, maybe we do better to start with this one. So it's variable gain super twisting. You see, now I'm trying to put it, to beat it as strong as I can. Nothing happened, even I'm trying to do something. So, and no chattering. So, and I'm not too generous, because my students told me that for the next experiment it was necessary to buy half a liter of tequila, but I haven't done it. So, no, sorry. This one. So that's 25 grams of pendulum. Half of little row of tequila. And that was, I was not too generous, but you see, it's still robust. So, that's just an illustration of something we can do with modern sliding mode control. Thank you. And also illustration that it is not to be generous enough. So many questions.
Hello, sir. Over here, sir.
Like you're using sliding mode controllers, right? So at times there might be situations we might require a single order, at times we might require second order, or we might require higher orders.
Yes.
So are there schemes, or can there be a scheme in which adaptive sliding controllers can be there? Like depending on the kind of system requirement, at times we may have a single order, at times we may have a third order, and the system can fuse all of them adaptively.
Okay, the point is adaptation. So let us to tell you the following. What you are paying for adaptation. What you need to adapt your system. Which information about perturbation you need.
Probably the system can give, or some statistical parameters on the perturbation can give us an idea on
this. Statistical, so what I need to reject perturbation, I just need to know the level of derivatives or the level of perturbation. If I need, for example, I know that I have the level of certain bounded of perturbation. What I need to put a level of control. And I will win it. You see, for example, if I know that the table is heavy, so I need to know how heavy it is. Otherwise, I will move it. If I know the border, I will be okay. Is it clear? Second stage. People to adapt, they need more information about perturbation. They need information how fast the perturbation can grow. Otherwise, you cannot be there. But if you need information how fast you will grow, you need the information about the next derivative. If you have the border of the next derivative, please grow the order and you will have automatic adaptation. You don't need adapt. The point is what you are paying for your adaptation. Because if your perturbation, you know that perturbation is smooth and you know the border, just grow the order and it will go down automatically. That's what superposing is doing. I've told twice during my presentation that when we are changing discontinuous control to continuous one, what we are doing, we need to ask the God that perturbation will be Lipschitz. So this means that we need to ask the God the level of velocity of perturbation. If we know that level, we will kill it exactly. We don't need to adapt. We will kill it in finite time. That's the religion I'm going to baptize here. The religion is you will be happy in finite time and also being not so strong in diet. That's the point. Okay, thank you. Thank you for your question. It was necessary to clarify. Some more?
Sir, I need to ask whether there is some work on frequency domain analysis of sliding mode control, because what is happening, order of system is increasing and in time domain it is difficult to find the constraints and other things. So is there any work in frequency domain?
Sorry, it was my error, because I brought a religion but I haven't shown you a Bible. So, we just wrote a textbook about modern sliding mode control. It was published in Springer in Birkhäuser. I'm one of the authors. And the chapter 5 of this book is devoted to analysis of all of sliding mode controllers in frequency domains. You can also just Google Friedman Yunnan, and you can find on my webpage, of course, what people are telling, there are 300 papers there, but there is a chapter devoted to frequency domain analysis of sliding mode controllers, and you can find there precisely the characteristics. You can use that both not only, for example, harmonic realization of describing function, but also exact method of analysis when you are putting all of Fourier series there, and it calls LPRS, locus perturbed relay system. That's you can find even precise analysis in frequency.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. So maybe it will be reasonable to show you also the Bible. Okay. It is, please.
Sir, I was working on unmatched uncertainty.
Okay.
By modification in the surface and by using superdistinct algorithm, what I was getting is either the position or velocity is stabilized. But one of that is stabilized, but the other always becomes the negation of disturbance. So
there is a joke in Mexico. People are telling that you cannot support two watermelons with one hand. It's difficult. So you are telling about unmatched uncertainty. You have to make a decision which watermelon you'd like to support. So you cannot do both. So I have a very big section of my papers devoted to precisely to compensation of matched perturbation and unmatched perturbation. The next paper is just accepted in Automatica, and that's precisely combination of identification of unmatched uncertainty with the backstepping, because what you need is to minimize the energy you are using in each step to stabilize, to compensate unmatched uncertainty. But pay attention, you cannot keep both watermelons. Or you are tracking exactly matched, or you are tracking exactly unmatched. And the second stage, I will tell you a very funny story which happened in 2000. In 2000, the CDC was in Australia, and we were walking together with my teacher, Professor Rothkin, in Sydney, near to the sea, and we met Professor Kakotovich. He is a friend of us, he studied in Russia, and he told to my teacher, Professor Rutkin, Vadim, you are still working in unmatched, but I am working in unmatched, and he mentioned backstepping. And Rutkin said, you are working about nothing. Why? Because imagine that you have input-output system. So if you will differentiate output, and you will have complete relative degree because we are speaking just about controllable system. So all of your uncertainty will compensate in the last equation. So you will never have unmatched uncertainty. That's not my viewpoint, that's viewpoint of my teacher, but I'm working in both. So you can find at least last 5 years, at least 10 papers by myself and I wrote a book, a chapter of the book together with Professor Bidman about that.
So I think it was indeed a very good enlightening talk by Professor Bidman. He brought out in a very short time the complete spectrum of sliding mode control, and I am sure his lecture, his talk would have added a great value to the researchers who are working in this field and probably motivate who are not. So let us thank Professor Bidman with our traditional style with great applause.